That is the first street I lived on when I was a child. I only lived there till I was 5 or 6. But it was such a difficult time. It was the 40s. And a lot of it is my parents' story. So I just pulled sections of my life for the whole book, but I wanted it to begin on Gibbon Street since that was the first part of my life. Anybody in the literary world who likes poetry, who likes short stories, who likes good photography would be drawn to it. The book has just a few sections. Alfred and Louise, of course, begins, and then places, water, love. Passages is the end. It's a very powerful section of the book. It's about death. It's about transitions, all sorts of transitions in life. I've written so much on my life, and I just started culling through and pulling out the things I wanted in the book, and it was like an 18-month process. It's a small book, but I bounced a lot of things off Lisette, and I would send them to her, and she would say yes or no.
I just think that even though it's set in the 40s, the timelessness of it lays in the emotional impact that people have with the relationships around them. And that's just timeless. It doesn't matter whether it's the 60s, 70s, 80s, or now.
Of course, Gibbon Street is, actually, this is me on the cover. Yeah. This is how little girls ran around back in the 40s. So you can get it at any bookstore, or you can get on my website, gibbonstreet.com, and order it from me.